It's Ryan here with another video, and today I'm gonna be unboxing and checking out the new Mac Mini M2. So if you're new here, smash that subscribe button and turn on post notifications so you don't miss my next video. So what I have here is the M2 Mac Mini that was released a few days ago. I picked up the base model with the 8-core CPU, 10-core GPU, 8GB of unified memory, and 256GB SSD storage, which comes in at $599 or $499 if you're a student on the Apple website. So let's unbox it and see what's different. Based on the box, you can already tell there's not much design change, but I guess what matters is what's on the inside, and that's the M2 chip. We already know what the M2 chip is capable of because we already have it in the MacBook Air and the MacBook Pro 13. But I'm excited to see what the M2 chip can do in a chassis that is better cooled like the Mac Mini. So inside the box, we get the usual Mac Mini on top. Then below that, we have the envelope with the paperwork, Apple sticker, and then we have a power cable. Pretty much the regular stuff. So when you look at the Mac Mini, you see that there's no design change from the previous generation. I have my 2018 Mac Mini here for reference, as well as my Mac Studio, and they're all the same shape. The Mac Studio is just taller. Let's talk about the port selection. So similar to the M1 Mac Mini, the base version that I picked up only has two USB-C / Thunderbolt 4 ports. There's also two USB-A 3.2 port, one HDMI 2.1 port, a headphone jack, and Ethernet that can be configured to support up to 10 gigabits per second. However, you can get four Thunderbolt 4 ports if you opt for the higher-end version. So the M2 chip inside this machine is faster than the regular M1 version. However, I have the Mac Studio here with the M1 Max chip with 32 gigabytes of memory and 512 gigabytes of storage, which is my main editing machine. So let's replace my Mac Studio with this new M2 Mac Mini and see what kind of performance we get, because I only edit videos on my Mac Studio. I will be testing the M2 Mac Mini to see if it could actually replace my main machine. My editing software of choice is Final Cut Pro, and I'm sure Apple Silicon is optimized for it because I've had no issues while editing on my Mac Studio. But before I get into Final Cut, let's open a few apps to see how it does, as well as run a few benchmarks. So as you can see here, the apps open really fast and the benchmark numbers are slightly higher for some of the tests, specifically the single core tests in Geekbench 5. But when it comes to multi-core performance, the Mac Studio is ahead by almost 50%. In Cinebench R23, the results are pretty much similar, with higher single core performance but lower multi-core performance. The disk speed in Blackmagic speed test is much faster on the Mac Studio, maybe because it has a 512GB SSD, while the M2 Mac Mini has a 256GB SSD. But when compared to an Intel MacBook Air, the speeds are night and day. But when it comes to reroll performance, the M2 Mac Mini is not as good as the M1 Max Mac Studio that I have. Normally, a 6-minute 4K H.264 video would take about 2 minutes and 36 seconds to export, but on the Mac Mini M2, it took 8 minutes and 12 seconds. Not sure why, but it did it completely silent despite being slower than the M1 Max. But I think that's because the Mac Studio has 14 more GPU cores, which I wasn't surprised to see because I had multiple layers of 4K video with text, audio, and color correction. Apple has also displayed a chart showing each chipset performance, even though it's in relation to the MacBook Pros. And for me, the tool that matters is the video transcoding and video editing. And as you can see, the M1 Max is ahead of the M2 Pro. And if the maxed out Mac Mini M2 was better than the M1 Max Mac Studio, there would be no need for Apple to keep selling the M1 Max Mac Studio in their Mac lineup. To me, a chipset is a chipset. The only difference is the enclosure. And I would argue that the Mac Studio has better thermals than the MacBook Pros. So I'll definitely get better sustained performance from my Mac Studio. But honestly, the base M2 Mac Mini is good value for money. You really get a lot of performance for just $599 or $499 if you're a student. So who is this Mac Mini M2 for? Well, anyone really. So if you're looking for a small desktop machine that can do some heavy lifting when you need it to, then this machine is for you. Also take into consideration that it is just a computer. You're gonna have to create a setup around it like I have here, with a monitor, keyboard and mouse, and possibly storage to streamline your workflow. So the Mac Mini M2 is a great machine, regardless of whether you're a video or photo editor, a programmer, or just a regular office worker. In the end, it all boils down to your budget and your work needs, and that will help you to determine what model you choose. The Mac Mini will provide great reliability, software update, and support that will make any user happy. But I would say, if you want the best desktop machine on a budget, get the Mac Mini M2 Pro. Paired with a nice monitor, keyboard, and mouse, you won't be disappointed. Especially if you're coming from an Intel machine, I would say go for it. But if you're already on M1, I would say wait for M3. But for me personally, I won't be upgrading to the M2 Mac Mini because my Mac Studio get the job done and it packs more performance than the M2 Mac Mini. I have more ports on my Mac Studio that I won't get on the M2 Mac Mini, regardless of the model I go with. And one such port is the SD card reader that everyone loves. So I think with my current setup, I won't need to upgrade for at least the next 2 years. So guys, that's it for my review and unboxing of the Mac Mini M2. Leave a thumbs up if you liked it. Thanks for watching and catch you guys in the next one. Peace.